Have you ever wondered how much discrimination there has been in this world just because of skin color? Well, this is about to change with the school millennials understanding exactly what the skin color is all about. The diversity in skin color makes our one human race a lot more colorful, just like the colors we see in a vegetable market or in a bouquet of flowers. But what is color? Physics teaches us that the color of an object comes from the wavelength of light that get reflected from an object and land on an observer's eyes. But for biologists, the story is different. We all know that sun emits radiations which contain UV rays that the human eye cannot see. These highly energetic radiations can penetrate deep into our skin and wreak havoc in the DNA of these cells, causing mutations which could eventually lead to skin cancer. Sun distributes the UV intensity differently across the globe, but nature is extremely intelligent and continues to make the needed adaptations. Following Darwin's law of natural selection, we know that the trait that suits the particular environment gets selected by the magical force of nature. What stands between the rays and us is our skin. The epidermal skin cells have small pouches called melanosomes. Inside these melanosomes is the cool superhero pigment called melanin. Melanin is of two types, reddish-white pheomelanin and dark brown eumelanin. When exposed to sun's rays, melanosomes form an umbrella over the nucleus to protect the DNA from harm. These closely packed melanosomes act as a proper shield and are collectively called the supranuclear cap. For example, the melanin that is found in African populations is the darker eumelanin, which results in a darker shade of skin as the UV intensity is the highest there. This natural sunscreen protects them from harmful solar radiations. Similarly, the type of melanin found in Europe is the pinkish-white pheomelanin, as the sun's rays there are milder. So, as we know, these umbrellas are essential for the survival of our species across the globe. But is UV totally bad for us? No. Some of the UV rays are important as they catalyze the production of important nutrients such as vitamin D. As humans started migrating, the skin experienced varying UV intensities. To adapt to this change, melanin diversified and transformed itself and became suitable for the region. Now that we travel a lot more across the globe, this adaptation becomes a little more tricky. People with lighter skin tones living close to the equator need to make sure that they apply extra sunscreen to protect them from cancer. Similarly, people with darker skin tones now living in regions with less UV intensity need to make sure that they get their vitamin D through additional sun exposure or other sources. So remember, one skin color is not superior to another.